Now that you've added your first app to Bitrise, let's take a look at what steps and workflows are. First, click the name of your app, then click on Workflow. This will open the Workflow Editor, where you will be able to set up a workflow for your app for any scenario or development stage you're in. On the left, you can find your steps. Steps represent blocks of script execution with predefined input and output variables. Put a sequence of steps together and you will get a workflow. There are two default workflows, one for testing and another one for deployment. The default workflows are different from each type of apps depending on the platform. Most of the time, a build is made up for a single workflow, but you can change this. This one here is the primary workflow for a Flutter app. It includes the Flutter install, Flutter analyze, and the Flutter test steps, which are all specific to Flutter apps. Steps represent a block of script execution with predefined input and output variables. Steps are basically the building blocks of your configuration. Workflows are made up of steps executed one after the other. You can already find some app-specific ones in the default workflows, but whenever you need to, you can delete them, rearrange them, or simply add new ones. If you click on the plus, you can see the step library, all filtered according to the platform you're working with. You can browse between all the different types of steps: test, deploy, notification, utility. Or you can search for a specific one, for example Slack. Once you've found it, just click it and it will pop up in your workflow. If you can't find the step you're looking for, you can always create your own. They are all open source, so knock yourself out. Let's try configuring some steps. How about we take a look at the Flutter test step? If you click on it, all of its input variables will appear to the right. Steps have two kinds of inputs, required and optional. If any of the required inputs do not have valid values, the step will fail. You can also get more information about an input by clicking on it. Environment variables or envors can be used as step inputs as well. You can modify a step input by either clicking into the input field and typing it in manually, or by clicking the change option next to the input field and then the purple insert variable button. Through here you can find a list of all available environment variables. Take a look at them, and when you find the one you're looking for, just click it and it will be inserted into the input field for you. If you can't find what you're looking for, no worries. You can set up envors, environmental variables, through the app's dedicated tab, located up here. There is a special type of envor called secret envor. Sensitive information should always be stored as secrets, as they will be redacted and not shown in build logs. You can create a secret envor by clicking on a step's input field marked sensitive. This one will be called top secret. I will add the random set of numbers as a value, then add it to the step. Later on, you will be able to find these under the secrets tab. You can make secret invores even safer by marking them protected, after which neither you nor anybody with the access to the app can unlock or check their values again. Your secrets will be safe with us. Now you know how to configure and customize steps and their inputs. And as for the workflows they are in, you can create new ones, chain them together, rearrange them, and just customize them any way you want to. When you're done with configuring everything, try running a new build. Click on the name of the app, then schedule the build. If you already feel comfortable enough with the workflow editor, you can also start thinking about further ways to build, test, and deploy your app.